Hi there everyone, my name is Stanczak, and in this video in particular, I'm going to be showing you how you can do a text tracking effect in PowerPoint. So without further ado, let's get started. Alright, so to start, I'm going to actually play the animation with the video in the background and then show you piece by piece on how to actually make this effect happen. Alright, so as you can see here in slide one, in the background, this is actually a video of a forest, and then we have all this text here, and I'm going to show you guys what this actually looks like. So we go into presentation mode, you'll see these trees are and names are going out in the distance, even more trees. Honestly, this example is super random, but I just wanted to give you guys a quick example of how you could actually make this similar effect that people usually do in After Effects in PowerPoint. So I'm going to show you guys how you can do this and how you can either use this for a presentation or even if you're trying to use this for a video. So if I go here into View Slide Master, you're going to see this is where I put my video. So you can grab any type of video you want on pixabay.com or pexels.com. None of those sites are sponsored. They're just my go-to sites for royalty-free high-quality videos. So feel free to explore there if you're looking for some high-quality videos to put in your presentation or even for any of your videos. And then once you find one, you can just insert it by going to Insert, video from my PC, and then you can pick that file. So I inserted this forest video, and this is what it looks like without any of the text. And you can see it's just moving along like that. And what I made sure to also do was in playback, I had it start automatically, loop until stopped. And then I also made sure that this right here was on play and not pause for the animation pane. Alright, so once you have your video in the Slide Master, you can then exit out of Slide Master. And now you can actually work with this canvas and try to add all this text. So to be honest with you guys, I have no idea why I actually went with this whole forest theme. It's just a random example, so don't take it to heart if you're like trying to figure out how to use this for a real use case. But you can probably do the same type of effect in a different type of video if you ever are looking for something similar. So with that in mind, I'm moving this text up here, and we're going to start with all this text that you see here. So all I did to bring in this text is I go into Insert, Text Box, and then you could type whatever you want here, like sample text, and then you can make it white. And then if you do Control Shift greater than sign, you can actually increase the size of that text. And for this case in particular, I actually used the font Lato and size 36. I also bolded it and had a text shadow. And that way it just pops off the video a little bit more and doesn't blend in as much, which is nice. So then what I did was I actually Googled what all these different trees were and added them in just to stay on theme. And then towards here, I was like, more trees, even more trees. I was like, we get the idea. All right, so now to actually get this effect of what you guys were wanting in this video. So as you can see here on this first one, what I have here, if you go to animation pane, I have a line animation, and then I also have a grow shrink animation. So it's actually pretty straightforward. So what I did was, and I'll copy this right here for you guys to see, and I'll remove these animations. All I did was I clicked on the text, added in the line animation, and then I also added in the grow shrink animation. And you want to make sure that you're always picking the animations from this drop down right here. Also, if you are still learning how to add video to a presentation, make sure to check out my previous video to show you on how to do that. So to continue with this tutorial, now I have this text right here, and I have the line animation and the grow shrink animation. And now what I need to do is make sure that when the video is playing, it looks like it's tagged to one of those trees and is moving with it. All right, so now I'm going to show you guys what this text right here looks like versus this text and why you need to do it a certain way at an angle versus just up and down for the video. All right, so I'm going to put in presentation mode. You'll see that that one goes at angle with the tree. This one just goes straight down. You can still do that type of effect, but I like doing it at an angle because it looks like it's coming with the video. As you can see, this video is a little curved, and it's also going with the drone footage at a curve, so that's why I did it at an angle. And another reason that I added in this grow shrink effect is because as you're getting closer to that text, I want to actually enlarge it so it looks like you're approaching that text and it's getting bigger and closer. And the farther away you are, the smaller it is. Just a little bit of perspective there for the visual, just to make it seem more real. So I basically did that effect to this text, and then I used the Animation Painter tool and clicked on this text and this text. And the only difference I really did with these two was I had a little bit more of a delay, so I didn't have this one start right away with this one. I had it wait a little bit. And then I also had the grow shrink happen a little bit longer. And then for this more trees effect, I had this one delay even more and grow a little bit longer as well. And in order to choose how much a text is going to grow, you can click on this yellow animation right here for the grow shrink in this drop down arrow, hit effect options, and then right here you'll see that here's the size. So for this one I chose 400%. You can obviously type in whatever number you'd want and then hit enter. I also did a smooth start so that way it's slowly gradually increasing and not all of a sudden drastically large. So I would recommend that as well to do a smooth start. And then I basically just copied the same exact concept on this side and had all these at an angle. So in order to get that line at an angle, all you have to do is click on that text and like let's say you want to do it for this one. You'll see here that there's these red dots. And you'll also see here that there's a green dot right here. So let me show you guys. So right here, there is a green dot, right? So you can choose actually where it starts. I just had it start where originally was placed, and then I choose where it's gonna end. So I have it going at this angle right here, and all you have to do is click on that dot, and you can choose, click and drag where you want it to end up. And you kind of have to just play with the video. So if you do have a second monitor, it really helps because what I did was I basically had the video and the whole presentation playing on a separate monitor while I was editing the location and messing around with where it should be placed. And then eventually I got to a point where it's gonna follow that one tree. But once you figure out where it's supposed to be located on the screen, it looks really nice. And then just as a finishing touch, what I did was I added in this text right here just to really emphasize that there's a lot of trees here. Again, this is a random example. I have no idea why I focused on the whole trees theme, but I thought it actually worked pretty well with this whole concept. So if I go into presentation mode, this is what you'll see. See the trees following for the most part. Obviously, it's not perfect. But to be able to do this in just PowerPoint and not have to go into After Effects to do the whole text tracking, I think this is amazing workaround for that. You can either use this for any of your videos or even for a presentation if you're wanting to really emphasize a group of different trees or whatever it may be in your presentation. So that is how you can accomplish text tracking in PowerPoint without having to use After Effects. If you did like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. Also, if you are interested in learning more about PowerPoint, I actually have a course on Udemy that covers all the best tools and features in PowerPoint, and I'll link to that in the description below. There's actually going to be a discount on that course for making it this far in the video. Lastly, let me know what you guys are looking for next. I love to take PowerPoint a step further and really try to be creative with it. So let me know if there's certain things that you guys are wanting to know more about. So without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Thanks.